Hello everyone, thank you so much for giving us a few moments of your time.
We would like to shed some light on the unfortunate situation of underprivileged children due to the pandemic.
As you know, the underprivileged kids of Mumbai have been affected quite severely by the coronavirus COVID-19 pandemic.
To tackle this, our club Mumbai City FC has partnered with Oscar Foundation to help these kids get an education during this period.
By supporting this cause, we can not only establish their children's future, but also secure the future of the city as a whole.
You can donate to this incredible campaign by clicking on the link. The details are given below.
And help create a positive impact.
Positive impact.
Very positive impact on our society.
It'll be really great if you can spread the word and share it amongst your friends and family and support this incredible cause.
We hope you can lend a hand in whatever way that you can, whether it is donating or even by spreading the word.
We hope you can lend us a hand by donating and spreading the word.
We hope you can lend us a hand by donating and spreading the word. Thank you.
Hello everyone and welcome back to Uzi Mumbai, the hub of everything Mumbai City FC. Before we begin, make sure to like that goddamn video, subscribe and click the bell icon to always stay updated about Mumbai City FC. So without further ado, let's get started.
Sergio Lobera has become a household name in Indian football in a matter of just 3 years. He brought joy to Goa fans by securing playoffs in every season he spent there. Following a row with the bigwigs at Goa, he was sacked before the end of the 2019-20 season. With his arrival to Mumbai being imminent, we have decided to do a video on how his system would function with the Islanders. With this video being the first of a two-part series, here we will only talk about the players he poached from Goa.
So let's see how FC Goa would line up under Sergio Lobera. They were primarily lined up in a 4-2-3-1 with Fall and Peña as the centre-backs, Mandaro Desai and Seritin Fernandez as the fullbacks, Ahmed Jahu and Lenny as the double pivot, Brandon Fernandez on the left, Jackie Chan on the right and Bumu through the centre and Koro up front. To maintain control, they often played out from the back. When Mandaro and Seritin pushed up, Jahu would often drop back with the to form a defensive three along with Fall and Peña. Lenny would stay in midfield and Brandon would drift in from the left hand side as Mandaro pushed higher up. Seritin did not venture out as much as Mandaro. Jackie stayed on the right flank and did not drift inward. Bumu did not come too deep as he preferred operating between the lines to transition the ball from defense to attack. Sometimes he would occupy the half space vacated by Brandon when he went in centrally, but often swapping positions wherever the space was vacated. Koro stayed around the edge of the box and finished off chances by himself or helped in setting up Bumu and Jackie. Naturally, when a team attacks more, they lose the ball more. So how did Goa choose to defend? Knowing that they were vulnerable in the spaces left behind by Mandaro, they counter-pressed immediately to win the ball back in the opposition half. Given the inferior standards of defending and technicality in the league, this became a very effective way of winning the ball back as it forced the opposition into making mistakes which led them to conceding. This is very well demonstrated by how they scored the second goal against Chennai FC away from home. German Preet has passing options cut out, so he's forced to play this long diagonal to Luis Angoyan. He's immediately pressed by Brandon Fernandez, where he fumbles and he loses possession, instantly creating a goal-scoring opportunity for himself. A classic example of how Goa press and win the ball high up the field to score or create opportunities for themselves.
It may seem like Goa have an emphasis on possession and can only progress that way, but this could not be further from the truth. As we can see on the graph, on the x-axis, we have counter-attacks ending with a shot, and on the y-axis, we have positional attacks which end with a shot. Positional attacks meaning the ones that come from possession and when your team has had the ball for long enough. It's evident that Goa leads in both of these categories, which shows how dangerous they are on both the counters and positional gameplay. This is because Lobera has set up a system and has recruited the right type of players who can excel in both formats. while we are talking about scoring, let's also talk about set pieces and how Goa scores from them. On this graph, we can see that on the y-axis, we have the number of set pieces won by the team. And on the x-axis, we can see the number of set pieces that end with a shot. BFC leads this list in both aspects because most of their gameplay was based on winning set pieces and scoring from free kicks or corners. Goa, being a team that scores mostly from open play, it's very impressive to see them high up on this list. They've won the second most number of set pieces that end in a shot, and third most number of set pieces in total. These points are color shaded on the basis of percentage of set pieces that end with a shot, meaning Goa has 36.2% of their set pieces ending with a shot. This is the highest in the league. And it's very impressive because Lobera also took out the time to make some very ingenious set piece patterns, and he even ended up scoring from quite a few of them.
So having discussed the basic tendencies of Lobera's Goa, let's get to the main point. What will be the effect of the former Goa players in this year's Mumbai City FC squad?
Let's begin with the signing of FC Goa's ex-captain Mandar Rao Desai. We think that he knew he was best used in Lobera's system and hence decided to leave his hometown. There were also talks of him having to take a pay cut, which he didn't seem to be on board with. Anyway, he is a very different kind of fullback, and it is evident why Lobera would specifically target him. Not many fullbacks in India have the ability to stretch out defenses like he does. His perception of space is brilliant, and his objective is to lure the opposition fullback out wide so he can create space for the winger or attacking mid to slip into. This exploitation of the half space is what makes Goa so dangerous while creating. Goals can be scored or assisted during this time, but just as it has its benefits, Mandar's wing is also the one that is exploited when opposition teams hit on the counter. This is where our star centre-back Mortada Fall comes into play.
Mortada Fall. When people talk about the best defender in India, one of the first names that come up is of Mortada Fall. He's physically imposing and is great at tackling. He boasts a pass completion of 87.57% and would work phenomenally in a team that values possession. To show how good he is defensively, without him, Goa conceded 28 goals, but after his arrival, that number dropped down to 20. A 28.5% difference. But it's his strength in set pieces that make him such a huge threat. He's often the man to be targeted for set pieces, hardly surprising given his strength and height. He either attacks the set piece himself, sets up the teammates by winning the first ball, or creates dummy runs to allow other players to tag the near post for a flick-on, a tactic often used by FC Goa. If rumours are to be believed, he turned down a better offer from ATK to play under Lobera. With his kind of passion, we know he can do wonders with Lobera at the helm.
Ahmed Jahu is arguably Lobera's most important player. He is an architect of play in all senses. He followed Lobera to India in 2017 and has been an instrumental part of Goa's success. His ability to find players with pinpoint long balls allows Goa to surpass midfield blocks and find quick players like Jackie Chand and Mandar. He is also a great ball winner as he wins 63% of his defensive challenges. For a team that plays with a large gap between a midfield and defensive lines, he does a great job to win the ball back. His ball playing ability can also lead to him initiating counter attacks. While in possession, he drops back into the defense to form a three-man backline where Fall and the other CB would go wide. He is very important in progressing the ball. Although he has shown minor signs of decline in the previous season, he is still 31 and could spend a great couple of years at Mumbai. Jahu's ball playing ability is immense. He is the designated free kick taker for Goa when they have won a set piece deep. He often gives pinpoint long balls to Mortada Fall, and they end up scoring quite a few goals this way.
Hugo Bumo. We've already talked a lot about Hugo Bumo in our last video and mentioned how he is the best player in the league, possibly the best there has ever been. But this time, we want to talk about him in a tactical context. At Goa, he often played the number 10 role, a very mobile number 10 that usually played behind Koro. Both players had a great understanding and off-the-ball movement that allowed them to play the killer passes and set up each other for scoring. A player like Bumo is very, very effective when it comes to breaking down tight defenses because he knows how to dribble and get past lines of defense. His finishing is good enough for him to finish off his own chances as well. When it comes to movement, his position is fluid depending on whether the other three Goa players are. If Brandon has drifted inwards and Mandar hasn't overlapped, Boomer would often play that role and go to the left. If Jackie is coming in narrow, Boomer would often move on to the right. His ability to play precise low crosses is very, very underrated because he is great at cutting back. Strikers like Ogbeche would thrive with the search service. His runs in defenders' blindsides are highly underrated as well. Despite being short, he goes in behind the defenders and manages to win headers or tap in easy chances. This is because he knows how to attack space and when to attack space. Now, having explained Lubera's style of play and each player's strengths, it's evident why he went for reliability over fresh blood. Their experience in the ISL and familiarity with the tactics will make it easier for the Mumbai squad to settle in and compete for the title. Well, that's it for the video. We hope you guys enjoyed it. Make sure to like, subscribe, comment and click that bell icon. And comment down below what you feel about Lubera and the players you signed so far. Well, I guess that's it for the video, and we'll see you soon.